Dimension 2 applicant destiny. Mankind has got to know his limitation.
Welcome once again to Show and Tell with your favorite teacher, Professor Dave.
Hello, class. I'm Professor Dave.
Hi, Professor Dave.
Today's lesson is Record Making 101. First step is finding a studio. Finding a studio. We chose Phoenix.
We're in Phoenix.
March 16th. It's about 6:20 in the morning. We're kicking ass.
The whole point of us coming to Phoenix to make this album was so we could get a house and convert the house into a studio. As things turned out, that didn't work out, and we're building a studio inside a warehouse now.
The second step is writing and rehearsing songs.
We are in a studio called Vintage Recorders in Phoenix. This is the final 2 weeks of our songwriting and arranging before we go into the next recording studio. This room sounds really good. The guys are happy with the tones. Yesterday they came in and did more work than they've done in weeks in any single day. So I'm really happy to be here. Of the things that Megadeth, the band, does seem to come from Dave. Dave is at the root of all fill in the blank. most of the songs as they create them start with a guitar pattern or a riff, and the guys will record their little riffs down and then bring them in, play them for each other and expand on them.
Does everybody know how the song goes now? Let's try it for real.
Class, if you're not aware, this is a long playing record that you can play on your high fidelity record player.
Hi, I'm Max. I do a bit of everything really these days. But Dave and I are the producers of the record.
Max designed the whole studio. Like I said, man, he's about as smart as they come. The only problem with Max is that he doesn't have red hair.
Max is a guy he shares the same vision that we have.
Hey Nick, how do you say getting faster in Italian?
I don't know, is that no crescendo?
Animato. Whatever it is. Okay.
Is it? Animato.
Animato?
Yeah. Animated. Animato.
Oh, I thought that was a sandwich.
Sounded like, yeah.
Anybody else tell us something like that? You know, we wouldn't really take it too seriously, but his opinion really matters to us.
I don't want you to hit bow, bow, bow.
Okay.
Bow.
You want E in there instead of B so it doesn't resolve already.
Yeah.
This is staying. This is staying. This is staying. This is staying. You need
four more for a verse.
Verse two.
Okay, so that's what I gave.
And then this comes back here.
For that.
And this goes right here.
I thought that verse was done.
Oh, two, three?
The way we just did that time.
Is that what happened then? I couldn't work out what happened.
The studio is being built, and when it's done, we'll be in there to record. Cool sky over there, man. You can't see that, though.
We've been working on this album for 2 months already, and we're not even in the studio, so we're at a much more leisurely, comfortable pace. We're changing things a million times.
That part should step up a couple beats there.
Kind of nice. Kind of groovy. Pretty boring though. I mean, pretty boring, you know. It's pretty nice when it's finished.
I can't get no respect.
See, you buy a nice car.
Right on the path.
Nobody wants to ride with you.
Jesus, dude, I don't want to ride with the tailgate monster.
We had a couple of guys jump in the fence the other day. So she got a dog out of the car and let the dog out, and then she put a couple of rounds over their head. They called
no,
and they went.
I did not.
That's all right. That's what these guys told me.
No, they're lying. I did not.
Not tougher than that dog right there. That dog's tough.
Here's my car right here. Come on inside.
Hi. Now this is a drummer's ride right here.
Oh no!
This is Mr. Chill. You heard of Mr. Bill? This is Mr. Chill.
Short of a disaster, there's no way this can't be the best album that we've ever done. It's absolutely impossible. I guarantee it.
Another week and a half, and then we're gonna break down all our gear, move it over to Cactus Ass Studios, and start recording album number 6.
We're going nuts just waiting here. It's like, this is killing us all this time. And this is a real test of patience. It's like, we're ready to deliver this baby, and it's, you know, it's like, it won't come out.
You know, when we go in there with the mentality that we're gonna fix a couple songs, we go in there and write new ones, so we got a whole another song to fix. If we go in there and we're just gonna goof around, we end up fixing songs. So it depends on what kind of mindset we have in there.
What the schedule is like down here? Well, we're looking at, we just got the glass today for the drum room, which is just about completed. We have to put in some lights in the drum room. Probably by Friday, the drum room will be complete. There's just so much stuff to do, and everyone's saying it's going to be done sooner than it really is. And I'm saying, you know, and I think that leaving a window and a margin for error, I would rather say the 14th of May and then do it earlier, but you know, I mean, we're looking at around the 4th or 5th of May to start.
It's too bad Max has to take all this apart and move it back to LA when we're done, huh?
We're certainly not going to be as retentive and nitpicky as we were on the last record. We're going to be a lot more free-flow kind of musical band ripping it out on this one. Everybody's kind of agreed to do that.
Rehearsal process went real well. Started that beginning of January. Went very, very well.
Why do I play drums? Well, I play drums because I love to play drums. Why do I want to play in Megadeth? I want to play in Megadeth because it's the most intense music I can think of that I want to play. I don't want to play anything heavier than that because I want to live to be 60.
Special measures during recording when we use a conventional setup so that he doesn't knock the stands over.
What did you fuck up now? Oh, you broke the fucking thermostat! You clumsy fucker. Now I gotta Did the battery fall out?
Yeah.
Dude.
Yeah, but one in here, dude.
Dude, it only takes one battery. The other one is when you replace it so you don't have to reprogram it, like I do now. Because you dropped the battery out.
Well, you should hide the motherfucker so people
you
won't step
You should be careful.
On.
This is a construction site still.
I am.
Bye, guys. I'll see you later, Max.
Dave is so intense and has such a vision of what he wants to do. And it is, you know, it's Dave's dream. And fortunately, he's been kind enough to dream me in it.
Step 3. Start recording.
We're starting today.
Hey, I can work with that. You guys got a bass that you're happy with yet?
We got a couple of basses we like.
I got a couple of them right here. I got this one. This one's a Padula. Fender Jazz Bass here. This one here is a Steinberger. This one actually sounds great. Looks goofy as all hell, but it sounds good. We got an old BC Rich Eagle.
I don't mind using that, just that with a double pedal. Just that.
This happens to be the neighborhood that our studio is in. You know, we wanted to go back to basics. You know, that's kind of the quote that everybody's saying these days, back to basics. This is about as back to basics as you can get.
The mouth almighty.
Hey, who's this? Fanzines, Megadeth, issue 2.
Yeah, that's true.
Is it from Italy?
No, England.
It says,
yeah.
Megadeth, issue 2.
We've got some questions we'd like to know, like when the new album's coming out.
No, probably
maybe you
don't.
Can tell us.
Live takes, it really puts the pressure on me because I only get one crack at it, you know.
Sometimes during the recording process, you make mistakes.
Thank you.
plays their part good and my part's not happening, then the take is really no good. And there's been instances where it's been a really good take and a really good feel, and I just wasn't happy with my performance on it. So we go back and we do it again.
Took me by surprise there, dude.
And mistakes.
Oh, I thought that you were listening.
It matters.
It sounds like it's like a Laurel and, World or something.
Laurel and Hardy soundtrack.
Now, you're gonna keep this on the track, right, Max? And get rid of Nick's drums, right?
That was the general idea, yeah.
That's the idea.
Right now we're moving along pretty fast.
This album just sounds a lot different than the other ones. You know, it's not like we've changed, we've just evolved. You know? A lot of it's just been preparation and pre-production and just listening to the songs, you know, recorded well so we can hear what the parts are. You can't really hear the stuff in a rehearsal environment, you know, you're playing and everyone's blasting out at full volume. But then when you listen to it on some speakers, you go, oh, that's what I'm playing there. Well, that doesn't sound good, let me change it.
I think there will be no mistaking that when you hear this, whether it be on somebody's CD player or on the radio, that you're going to know that it's Megadeth.
It's just a little touch hotter than it was last time, Bruce. Wow. Max, can I have a second to have a drink here?
On the top, it's just...
Oh, no, no.
Oh, they play two there?
Yeah.
Way okay. Too hot. Way too hot. I'm going to drop it.
That one didn't count anyway.
Jesus Christ. Be sure and stick your tongue right in there.
It's a Bavarian coffee mug.
Hey. God, when he dipped his helmet in there, it didn't seem that hot.
I was so busy dreaming of grooving.
I thought you were Santana there for a minute.
Santa Fe.
These are my classroom rules. 1. Follow all directions. 2. Quiet when teacher is talking. 3. Keep hands, feet, and objects to yourself. 4. No cussing, teasing, and fighting. 5. Work quietly at your table.
The most important thing for us right now is we just make the best record that we can.
Down, 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 damn it.
Notice everybody has to change their stuff but me. I'm great at everything I do.
You getting everything you need? Hope so.
John is playing the Friday.
See the red lines? Those are the ones we've already tried in E flat. These ones. The red lines going this way are the ones we've already got done.
Sometimes during the recording process, you'll be interrupted by photographers.
Right then, gents, we're right against the wall. Let's do a photo or two of you. Any objections? Not that I would particularly listen anyway. Marty, can you bring your neck in a bit so I don't have to be so wide?
Guitar neck either round or up. Yeah, yeah, perfect. Chin down, Marty, not your head up. Good.
Every magazine and television program in the world thinks he's Marty and that he's Nick.
Suck.
What a compliment.
Get a fake ID that says Marty Friedman on it, so when I go get pulled over, I can whip out my ID and go,
for soliciting prostitution.
All right, Marty, I'm going to write you a citation this time. I'm going to crumple it up and throw it out the window.
Meetings with art directors.
Without being contrived, I'm really pleased with the two pieces. One that they haven't seen yet, Megadeth's last piece, Countdown to Extinction. I was very pleased with that, and I think the band was too. I was also very pleased with the current piece I've done. Again, we're standing in a room with the piece that they haven't even seen yet. So, hopefully they'll feel the same way. You'll know shortly.
Dude, you spelled euthanasia right.
Yes, I did.
All right.
With that, at least takes
you. Fucking great, dude.
Thanks.
She ain't that fat, though.
No, I don't think she should be.
Wow. Dude, totally Dolly-esque.
They're only hanging by 1 foot.
By a tub, nevertheless.
I thought you can hang them by at least both feet.
Some
dude.
Do, some don't. Some are facing forward, some are facing back.
Wow, that looks cool, man.
How'd you shoot these kids?
That looks
they
really
like
cool.
Laying down or what?
Yeah, laying on an acrylic sheet. We shot them through a hole in the ceiling. We had a three-story studio.
Let me see.
Had that.
You don't have the Megadeth logo?
Megadeth logo is being illustrated with you. And then I find out from right yesterday that you guys were
looking
for...
Well, I was hoping you'd hit a home run. I'd say grand slam.
Why, thank you.
Meetings with record company executives.
All right. This one's called Euthanasia. We could, like, have a release party at a hospital. The children's hospital.
Hey, how about a mortuary?
Awesome.
Well, Gary's idea...
Mortuary would be cooler in a cemetery.
Gary's idea would... Gary Gersh's idea of doing the MTV-driven Halloween release party. Promotion would also be a release party. If we had Dr. Kevorkian at our party, that would be awesome.
That's pretty morbid, don't you?
Yeah, that's kind of creepy. I don't think it's any morbid than having a baby hanging on a clothesline with a CD in his head. I mean, come on. They're going to look at that and go, boy, are these guys out there.
I think we're gonna jam on this side of the
room. A little
except for one spot. That was great. I got one little spot I just need to fix. That was great.
Yeah, that was pretty rocking.
How was that for you today, Nick?
I made a mistake in the first chorus.
I thought that was pretty good tight, though.
Come on in. Let's see what's happening today.
That's a good tip for all you engineers out there. Good idea to roll back.
Yeah.
All you guitar players out there, wait for the vocals.
Roll them.
It is now, I guess.
Okay, I like that a lot better going up. I think it gives more tension to the whole thing.
One day you walk good. I said that needs me. Does that make me wrong? Am I your weak man? Are you feeling strong? My heart was blackened. It's bloody red. A hole in my heart. A hole in my head.
Yeah. Better, better.
Once more, please.
Minute workout right there.
This is like how a song should sound if you've only got a little bit of time to hear it.
After he redoes his drum part, we'll say, hey, you know, maybe I should change my guitar part too. And then after that's done, maybe the vocals will have to change because of the guitar part changing, and we'll basically be doing that whole album over again.
Let's see. Thursday, yeah. Heard a few songs today. Great vocals.
Could we just talk about the photos?
How about doing a group photo?
I think that's a good idea, having a band shot for centerfold like we did with Rest in Peace.
Kind of like the vibe of where we're at right now. A group photo would be kind of hip, you know?
You had an idea that was to use Abaddon to shoot this. Which would be quite something, but also logistically, I know you guys are plugged in here for the month of July, and if we can get him here, that's one aspect, and Ron and I are going to go and try to
work on. Where's he located?
Out of New York.
I'll fly to New York to see this.
I mean, Max has so much work to do downstairs, we can go. I want to eat pizza, I want to go to the photo shoot, do that, go back to the hotel room and see.
Bill, hey, David.
Hi,
how are you?
Marty.
Hi.
Adrian.
Hey, how you doing?
Hi.
Nick.
I'll hang these up for you.
Good, nice to meet you.
I'm so excited to do this. Hi, guys. How are you?
Nick.
Nick.
Dave.
Ron.
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 You're Ron.
I'm Ron.
I'm Marty.
Dave's in the bathroom.
He has red hair.
He does.
I've only seen black and white pictures. So.
Hi, how are you?
Hi there.
Here in New York doing a photo shoot for the album.
Dave.
Come on. Are you Dave?
There's something
oh.
that I thought would be
You're Dave?
Important.
Yeah.
So
it's not such red hair.
Really
I've been getting tired to separate you by hair. When we first started, we wanted to be, you know, a huge metal band.
There's just so much I can do. I can have wild hair flying and deep lighting.
And then we kind of were trying to lay low.
I can make it dramatic. I can do it the way I did the Beatles in black and white, kind of romantic. I can do this. I can do all of it.
And then it's like this, how can you lay low when you're doing a photo shoot with the biggest photographer of all time?
Our whole attitude going into it was to not have any limitations, which we sometimes had in the past, and that right there was a turning point for us to just be able to open to whatever Richard had to suggest to us.
Say this is the most professional photo shoot that we've ever done, and it's really nice to work with somebody that knows what they want and how to get it, and the pictures will speak for themselves. I'm very excited to see how they're going to come out.
Now, this is the apex of our career working with photographers. I mean, this is the best that it's been so far. I don't think we'll be able to surpass this. It's been a wonderful experience, and we've learned a lot. Hopefully it'll turn out and we might have to come back and beat the hell out of them.
Such fun. You don't know what my life is like usually.
It's so easy.
Boring. This is so good. You could eat pizza all around the United States. 49 states, the pizza sucks. New York, can't go wrong. You just can't. When you eat the pizza here, I mean, unless the guy wipes his dick on it or something when you're not looking.
Making records is not all fun and games, as Billy found out. You must work, work, and work even harder.
Dude, have you seen my new guitar shape?
No, the list title.
Dude, that's a guitar.
Yeah, the thing coming in was pretty cool. I think you can play it better.
Okay. This week I've been soloing. I've been soloing a lot. I got the solo to Euthanasia. Dude, I've used a Strat. Don't tell anybody, but I've actually recorded on an album with a guitar that's not a cool shape. I've actually used this guitar on tracks. Look at this shape. Look at the color. You could, like, drink coffee off this guitar. It's just one big mess of rocking. Though I got a lot of challenging stuff going on guitar wise because I come to this point where Max says, oh, you repeated yourself. Now these guitars are rock worthy, man. I use this on Addicted to Chaos. Sometimes it even gets by me because I get so involved with what I'm doing that I can't tell that it's similar to what I did in the other song 2 weeks ago.
Now that Marty's putting all the extra guitar parts on it, you know, all the little embellishments, the acoustic parts, the clean parts, starting to put some solos on it. It's really starting to come together right now. Really starting to get a... starting to sound like a record, man.
En fait, je suis arrivé hier de Paris pour causer à notre bon ami Dave Mustaine de la façon dont il doit employer ses cordes vocales pour bien chanter français.
You ready to help me with this?
Of course, I'm ready.
Good, good. I gotta make a couple phone calls. Have you met Max yet?
Phil.
Hi, how are you?
I got a phone call from New York, Capitol EMI, asking me to join the studio. I mean, to get in the studio the day after to show Dave Mustaine how to sing in French.
A tout le monde. Okay.
Tous mes amis.
Tous mes amis.
Easy, very easy. Je vous aime.
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 That's it. Je dois partir.
Je dois partir.
Je dois partir.
Je dois partir.
Je dois.
Je dois
partir.
Partir. I'm gonna have trouble with that. I can already tell.
À tout le monde. I was ready to go, man.
We can change the word, you know.
You got another word? I gotta leave.
Yeah.
Okay.
Listen to
I said may and not meh. Mez and me. Okay. One more time, Max. I do the moon. Do mess of me. Je vous aime. Je dois partir. These are the last words I'll ever speak. And they'll set me free. Better?
Not better.
No. And they will have you sing one too.
Hmm?
Just so you can say you sang on the record.
A tout le monde, à tous mes amis, je vous aime, je dois partir. These are the last words I'll ever speak, and they'll set me free. A tout le monde, à tous mes amis, je vous aime, je dois partir. These are the last words I'll ever speak, and they'll set me free.
Yeah, that's great. Sounds good.
You understand?
Right on.
I wish I had a harmonica. I'd go out there and blow a solo for you guys.
They have these little percussion things, little shakers, maybe tambourines, things that, like, on by themselves are like the goofiest friggin' instruments.
He'll come in here and everybody will be sitting here on my
mouth or something. Hi, I'm Jimmy Wood.
Hi, Jimmy. How
nice to see you, buddy.
You too.
All right. Are you hearing anything in there?
G flat? Yeah. What is that? Is that a D flat?
A flat.
A flat?
Well, we'll see what happens here. Sounds. Mm-hmm. Let's look at the amplophones.
You can do it. Okay.
You want to try another one of these?
Sure.
It's just too heavy.
Yeah.
Too aggressive.
Too heavy for Megadeth, huh, Marty?
It's just too heavy for anybody.
Come ride. Follow me and I'll tell you. I was down at the studio earlier today listening to Addicted to Chaos and Train of Consequences, which I have to say is my favorite song right now. Train of Consequences is just rocking. Hello, my name is Trouble.
We know everything about when this record's coming out, the album cover, the title, the pictures, everything you could possibly know about this record, we know. Because we've taken our time to do it.
What? Nick said he wanted something a little more
alternative sounding.
Alternative to what?
I need to get that last note if I'm going to keep any of that.
Marty.
Yes.
Touch my guitar.
Okay. It's too beefy.
Is the angle of the ride hitting the stick? Give me one good reason why we should do it.
Because we've got all of our shit set up and we have tones and we're one song away from finishing everything we wrote.
Give me another good reason.
We're almost done. I should be done today. I've got 12 things to do.
Yeah, we're nearly done. I got a lot of work to do, but we're nearly done singing. He's got to sing one more song. He's got to put the choruses on this one. We've done all the solos, I think. Got a couple more little guitar bits to do. Got some harmony stuff to do. We'll be mixing in about a week and a half. Hey, gotta like that.
After you finish recording the record, the next step is you must mix the record. Step 4, mixing the record.
Mixing is, we record all this stuff and we record like the snare goes on one track, the kick drum goes on another track. The guitars each go on their own track. The solo goes on its own track. The solo fills probably go on a different track. Like I have 48 tracks, so I have plenty of room. It's difficult to describe the mixing process because it's somewhat of an intuitive thing. The whole point of a good mix is really to have the listener obtain through each section of the music, not let the listener down, not let the listener lose confidence or lose focus in the song. You do whatever you have to do to create the focus all the way through the song. mixing is a lot easier if the track is recorded right. This was pretty easy record to mix, actually. We got everything right in the first place, I guess, which is lucky. That doesn't always happen.
So I'll do the choruses and we'll finish that one, and then I can either do Victory or Thought I Knew.
Yeah, let's do Victory then.
Yeah, we'll get one of those done besides the choruses today.
And he started playing, he goes, come on! He's kind of had your vibe a little bit. I was a little surprised. I was like, wow, man, you're going to fucking diss this kid in front of everybody, man. And the guy comes up, he tries to start.
What do you mean he had my vibe?
He kind of like had a little bit of a vibe. Like, come on up here. No, it was kind of cool. He had a bit of an attitude. It was kind of a cool thing.
Well, that one guy who actually did sing.
One guy actually did it pretty good.
He did.
It's kind of a hip idea, though, having a kid come up and like sing a song, you know.
What do you think? We'll have someone come up and play the bass?
We're done right now.
As far as I'm concerned, I'm done. As far as Dave's concerned, I'm done. As far as David's concerned, I'm done. As far as Mac's concerned, I'm done. What do you say?
The last step, mastering the record.
If production is just one massive turd polish, then mastering is wiping its ass. I get a Bob Ludwig, who I consider to be one of the best, or the best in the industry. He's up in Maine, Portland, Maine. Yeah. Mastering is putting all the songs together next to each other, closing them so that the gaps are correct between the songs, EQing and possibly compressing each song to get the most out of it, to make it sound the best. You know, different days I might mix something duller, I might mix something brighter. The mastering process levels that out. Because I take all the mixes that I do, because I do, you know, variation mixes, and at that point we make the final decisions about, you know, which mixes to use and the way to treat them.
And there's subtle EQ stuff going on that just basically gives it the final sheen and sound and character that it should have, you know. I mean, sky's the best there is.
And that's about it. That's it. And then everybody rushes out and buys it, hopefully.
After you follow these five easy steps, you'll have one of these beautiful records.
Cup of Joe. Time to go.
See ya!
I'm taking all your money. I
Okay, you asked for it. When the music comes on, you're up here dancing, or you get the dunce cap. I could be a real cool teacher.
Okay.
No school today.
All right.
Oh, teachers. What a sacred word. And we chose Phoenix. Hey, this guy's making a face at me. I can't help it. Okay. Is that your little sister? Do you ever beat her up?
Yeah.
Really? That's cool.
Ready?
You want some money for this?
Yeah!
Parents, you hear this? As Billy found out, you must work, work, and work even harder. making videos will never be the same. Wait a second. You're gonna pay for this, Jeff.
Now that the studio is finished, the band.
Okay, settle down. Ensuing anarchy, we better hurry. What are you laughing at? Yeah, how about you wearing those boys' shoes? Class is almost over. You guys are all gonna get ice cream and chili.
Alright!
Jason, you got your shot?
You might not.
Yes, okay.